Alan Watt is a long-term researcher into the causative forces behind major changes in historical development. With historical documentation, he shows how cultures are created and altered by those in control, always to lead the people, like sheep, into the next pasture. I spoke to Alan Watt and I asked him what he reads into the fact that people in Greece and in other countries of the world are feeling uneasy about where the global financial crisis might lead.
I personally think it's simply the next stage that was planned by those who set up and planned the economic union in the first place. Because if you go into the writings of John Maynard Keynes, who set up the structure for this kind of economy that we're in today, where it's basically a debt-based economy with nothing to back up money in itself except more and more loans and selling off the loans for interest, etc. He said that the next phase would be a structured world system, a global system, and that's where the IMF came into it. The IMF was eventually to come into its second phase, where it became the distributor of debt. Initially, the regions, which is now the European Union, first part of it, and then for the whole world in itself. This last financial crash we've had altogether seems to be tied right into this whole elevation of the IMF into what it was originally set up to be in the first place. And unfortunately, that picks Greece as to be the example to the rest of the world. They're saying we can't go on like this. We need a global structure to distribute debt through the World Bank, and countries are simply inept to handling their own finances anymore. This is the start of this, and they pick Greece as the example.
What are they trying to accomplish, ultimately?
To take away a form of sovereignty over your own distribution of money, your own governmental management of money, and the IMF and the World Bank eventually permanently be in charge of distributing the wealth of the world to different regions, as they call it, the nations. Now you're part of a region, and to them it's more efficient, it's more power for the world system. It's a global system, and they're telling us already we can't go on in this way where countries are borrowing money and spending money and not taking care of the bookkeeping properly. The world bankers, remember, there's only a few world bankers, but banking families that comprise the World Bank. These are the same banking families that lend to each nation at present individually. If they can do it through a world banking system, that takes care of their problem, less work for them, and every country will be forced eventually to sign on to this new system. They're also talking about bringing in, of course, a new global currency altogether, and that's also part of the structured system they're talking about. But as I say, you have to go into the writings in the 1940s and the 50s of the big players who set up the International Monetary Fund. And personally, this whole crash was planned, as far as I'm concerned. They keep saying that Greece cooked the books to get into the economic union. Now, there's not a country in Europe that didn't cook the book. In fact, the general public don't even know what the books contain. So that's nonsense in itself. This is a move, as I say, to push forward by using an example or creating an example that we can't go on this way anymore, and nations cannot be responsible for the kinds of money they're borrowing and spending on their own people.
What period of past history does today's situation remind you of?
Well, they've done this before. We've had crashes, many crashes before, from the 1800s right through into the 20s and 30s. We were pulled out of it the last time simply by World War II and a brief period of production because of the factories produced during World War II. Now they've been taken away because they decided to put most of them in China. We're on a service-based economy. What's interesting about Greece, too, is Greece is one of the biggest service-based economies where very little is really produced internally. It's mainly imported and then distributed through different middlemen around the people. It's a service-based economy. However, we also know that at world meetings with the World Bank and the IMF, the big players have written themselves about the need to bring in a global system, and that countries really are obsolete. Countries are obsolete. Nations are obsolete. The old-fashioned way of dealing with your own country locally is obsolete, and they want a centralized power to deal with all resources. That includes all the resources you have, for instance, in your country, and all the spin-offs from those particular resources. And we also have infighting going on. I don't know if it's really infighting. It's really clubs. The European Union is formed by internal clubs above those which most people see in the Union itself, and very wealthy clubs. There's a big play on at the moment for Dutch and German companies to take over even the tanker industry, the world tanker industry for carrying goods across the oceans. Greece is a big player in that. It has sort of sovereignty over its own affairs there. I think they're going for this kind of thing. This might even be part of the deal that we'll come to with Greece to give up the rights to your natural resources to a great extent, maybe completely even, and also to your abilities to keep the big tanker industries going. I know Maersk really wants to rule the seas, and the big banks in Germany are backing them to take over.
And that was researcher Alan Watt.